H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Yeah, I would appreciate if you can do it parallelly with me, then if you have any problem, I can tell it to you right away. So go to the SQL class and then do sys as sysdba, okay? And in the password, just press enter. Once you go there, write this thing. Let's alter user HR identified by HR. Okay, then do grant DBA to HR and then do alter user HR account unlock. Let me know once you have done this.
I have managed, Shobhan.
You're done it? Okay. So now, once this is done, what you'll do is we'll close this and we'll try to reconnect again in SQL class, but this time we'll use HR and password also HR. Okay? And then do select star from tab. That way you will be able to see how many tables are there in the HR schema. Okay, so that way now you have access to HR schema. Now first thing what you have to do is before to connect to the database, what you have to do is go source analyzer and do source import from database, okay. You'll do import from database, and here you will not see any ODBCs. So right now I have created two ODBC, HR and HR1. You will not see those. So you will basically see DBS, Excel, MS. So after that, you go here and you do a create. Okay, system. So I'll create one and data source, and I will use Data Direct 6.0 Oracle WAD protocol. And data source name you can put anything. So right now I'm putting HR_dev. So usually we give a name which is something relevant so that in future we can. In real world, you will have so many connections, so that if you don't give some relevant name, then in future it's very tough to understand which ODBC is connecting to which schema. Okay, so for this one, I'll use local host. Port is 1521. For my SID is ORCL, I'll do a test connection. It will ask me username and password. I'll give the user ID as HR, password as HR. Click OK. So it says connection established. So apply, OK, OK. So now in the drop-down list, you will see the one which you created, which is HR_dev. Now I'll give the username password one more time, HR, and I'll do connect. Once I do that, I can see all the tables present in that HR schema. So this is how you have to connect to any of the databases. So now, let's say I want to read the employees table. So I'll click it and click OK. Now if you look here, the data types are taken automatically because it's a table, so everything is defined in the underlying DDL, right? So you can see everything which you are taking is actually correct. I want to remove the manager IDs falling in the same table. Not a key. Okay. You got it? So now what I'll do is I'll do a straight mapping like we did earlier, where I'll read the data from database and write it into a flat file. Okay. So basically what I can do is I can copy this one and go back to DB, paste it, but this source and source qualifier are different, so I'll remove them and I'll bring the source from sources and let's see. Employee ID is connected to employee ID, first name is connected to first name, last name is connected to last name. Salary is connected to salary, commissions is connected to commissions, department ID is connected to department ID. Phone number is connected to phone number. Now you can see the data type here is and the data type whatever is here are not same. Okay, so what I can do is I can, because in the real world you will find like there is a very big mapping. Okay, and maybe you have to do the data type change, like you change the data type in one of these transformations, and after that there are maybe 10-15 other transformations. So you have to go each and every transformation and change the data type. The easiest way to do that is, what I want to do is, I want to, so I know these data type are actually correct. So what I'm going to do is, I'll do a select all, right click, and do propagate attributes. And then what I want to do is, I want to do propagate it, all this, this data type, precision, scale, description, everything. So I'll do propagate and close. So now if you look here, all the data types are in sync with the previous transformations. So this is a quick way to do the changes of the data type. Okay. Now let's save this. So try to understand, okay, I'll come to that later. Okay. Let's go to Workflow Manager. Now in Workflow Manager, you will see there is a menu called Connection. So you are trying to connect to a relational database, right? So you go to Relation, and what type of database is it? It's Oracle. And I already created one, so we'll create one more. Okay, so I'll create a new and Oracle, and you. So I'll give the name as, let's say, HR_Dev. Okay, and give the name as So username is HR, password is HR, connection string is my OSCL. Okay. Click OK. Close. So I have to do that before I create the workflow. Why? Let's now try to create the workflow, you will come to know. So when I'm generating the workflow, see, it automatically took HR connection object, but I don't want to use the HR connection. I want to use HR dev connection object. Okay. So you can change it here. You can change it later on also. I'll show you. Let's go back here. And disconnect. Connect. Okay. Now this is my source qualifier. Earlier we, I'm sorry, this is not the correct. I'm going to have to incorrect workflow. This is my correct workflow. So this is my source qualifier. Earlier, what you have, if you remember, what you used to do is we had to give the source file name and source directory name. But now, since we are connecting to a database, we don't give source file name and directory name. What we have to do is we have to choose the connection from here. So let's say I have 10 connections. Out of those 10 connections, which is my actual connection. So I have to choose that one. But since my target is still a flat file, what I have to do is I have to give the details of the directory and the file name. So it's cpgt files. And let's say oracle underscore new underscore db and txt. Apply. Okay. Let's run and see. Okay, it has read 107 records, it has loaded 107 records, okay. Now, let's go to the target, this is my new file, let's see how it looks like. So this is how it looks like, okay, the file. There may be some problem with this telephone number conversion. Anyway, so, now try to understand this. We have created the connection twice, right? One for the designer and one for the workflow manager. What is the difference? As I told you earlier, that this work Power Center designer is a place only to create the blueprint. So this is a place where you do the design, right? Here we don't deal with the data, right? Even if when you have used the flat file or you use the database, we imported the structure of the table, right? It's not the actual data, it's only the structure of the table. But when you are running this station, at this point you have to know, right, which database you have to connect and how will you extract the data. So this is the place where Informatica is actually connecting to the Oracle and reading the data. Any questions? Anyone, any question? No?
No, Shobhan. Thanks.
No or yes?
No, Shobhan.
Oh, okay. Thank you. So now what I want you to do is, this is assignment. You will first do whatever I have done. Next is, instead of loading the data into this file, okay, right now we are loading the data to some flat file, right? What is that flat file name? This flat file. I want you to load the data into a table. So what you have to do is, you have to create a table in, so basically the steps are, you will have to first create a table. Okay, let me just write down the steps for you. So first step would be create a table in, let's make it a little complicated so that you can, that way you'll learn more. Okay. So first is, create a schema of your own. So anyone who couldn't understand this line,
I can't understand that.
Sure. Okay. So that means HR is one schema, right? Similarly, I want you to create your own schema. So your syntax will be, you will log in as sys, as sysdba, and then password will be just what, enter, and then you will write this, create schema, sorry, create user, and then give some username, okay? Let's say your name, okay? Let's give some generic name so that somebody wants to watch this video. So let's say ASSIGN, assignment. So create user assignment identified by ASSIGN, assign. Okay? And then you write grant DBA to ASSIGN. Okay, once you do this, then if you try to log in with user AS, so this is your first thing. So that way, you, now you have a separate user schema like HR of your own, but that schema does not have any table. Like HR has so many tables, right? I showed you. HR. Oops, select star from HR. From tab. So these are the tables already present in HR, but I want you to create your own schema where there will be no table. You can also, if you don't feel comfortable with this black and white screen, what you can do is you can try using this one. This is more user friendly. So go to Oracle and go to this thing, Database Control OSCL. Okay, let's say HR. Okay, once you reach this page, go down, you'll see SQL worksheet. Click on that. So this is more user friendly and in a tabular form. So if you don't like the black screen, then you can use this one. So it will be like select star from tab and select and execute. So it will show you what are the tables. Got it? So it's up to you. Whatever you feel comfortable, use this. But this is your first step. So once you have your own schema, second step is create a table similar to the flat file target. So that means you will create a table which is similar to this one. Serial number, employee ID, employee full name, net salary, telephone number, department. So the syntax for this is you have to do a little Google search or the document which I have given you. It will be like create table and then give the table name as employee_target. Okay. And then the column names. So that's the creation of the table. Once that is done, then number three is create a mapping with hr.employees as source and this assign, right? Assign is another schema. Assign dot employee target is your target. Let's make it employee TGT. Okay. So then you load the data into this new target table. So any questions? Anyone, any question? So to do this assignment, basically you have to create it two ODBC connections here. Just giving you some hints. So you have to create two ODBC connections here, okay, and then one for your HR schema and one for your own schema assigned, and then for in workflow manager also you have to create two connections. One for your HR schema and one for your assigned schema. And then in the while in the session you will see like source qualify, you will see a drop down list of all the connections will come for the target. So you select the assigned schema for target and HR schema for source. Any questions? Any question regarding the assignment? No. So you want me to continue or you want to do some practice and then we can meet on Wednesday? What do you want to do? Hello?
It's you, all right, Shobhan. Anything is good with me.
Okay, then let's do one thing. Let's keep this much for today, and then you do the database connection, read the data from employees table, and load it to a different table, and then we'll do. Some transformation next class. So next class is Wednesday, and we'll have some little long session, maybe 1.5 hour or 2 hour session. I'll try to finish some of the important transformations by then. Okay?
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.